So we have two types of corruption na very prominent during the time of Rizal. It's nepotism and then bribery. So under this slide, we have three popular governor generals who were very corrupt according dun sa reference natin. So when we say governor general, the equivalent rank of a governor general for our time is our president. Itingin ko po, the governor general is the ang equivalent rating ranking ng governor general during the time of Rizal is our president. Ang three most corrupt officials, as an example given in this slide, are these three governor generals. First is Rafael de Izquierdo. In order for us to easily remember, Rafael de Izquierdo is Rafael from the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. So if you're familiar with Rafael, you can Google it out. Sa Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles, merong isang character doon. It's Rafael. Apat sila. So si Rafael de Izquierdo is responsible for executing the Gumburza. Okay, the Gumburza are significant priests in the life of Rizal. So si Gumburza, pinaglaban nila yung isa sa mga pinaglaban nila is the freedom and secularism of religion bilang separate entity from the Spanish government. But hindi yun na materialize mainly because of Rafael de Izquierdo. Again, Rafael de Izquierdo, in order for us to easily remember it, we have to remember Rafael from the Ninja Turtles. Andun si Rafael, andun si Rafael. So next is Camilo de la Polavieja. Camilo de la Polavieja, we remember the red here. Red here that's present in the knife. Yung red dyan is blood. Blood, which is color red. Andun yung pola, andun yung red blood. So red blood here pertains to the murder or the execution of Rizal. Si Camilo de Polavieja is responsible for the death of Rizal. Tandaan lang po natin yung last name ni Polavieja, which is Polavieja, yung pula. And then the red here, then the blood. So Polavieja responsible dito sa execution of Rizal. This is Bagong Bayan ayon sa Rizal. This is an actual photo of Rizal, Rizal's execution. And then this two remaining governor general, again, ulitin ko po, governor general, equivalent rank for that is the president of the country, or president of our country. So parang si, ano to, si Duterte right now. So si De Rivera and then Weyler, ang dalawang governor general to are known for bribery. Okay, nababayaran. Nababayaran in order for these officials to favor your position. So isa yan sa mga examples ng corrupt officials. Now let's go to the next slide. Sa next slide, Spain lost some of its colonies as mentioned a while ago in my previous slides. Nawala sa Espanya yung Latin America. Now, if you are living in that territories, there's a big chance that you're going to transfer to another territories. And then, yun yung ginawa ng mga ibang local Spaniards dun sa territories na yun. So, wala na silang, there's no more chance for them to be productive in their territory. That's why they transfer to another territory. One of which is our country, the Philippines. Wala silang pagkakakitaan doon, lumipat sila sa Pilipinas, and then they try to marry, ito, they try to marry, this one, they try to marry Pilipinas na mayayaman. Okay, so for the Filipinos, for the Filipinas, they have this stereotypical impression if a person who has this type of skin color, medyo superior yung impression ng mga Pilipino, superior yung race na yan. So kung mayaman kang Pilipina, mayaman kang Pilipino, you belong in a very rich Filipino family, you'd rather attach yourself to a superior race as well. Okay, that's the reason we have, I think right now, meron tayong mga Ayala, meron tayong mga Sobel. Yan yung mga dahilan kung bakit mayaman pa rin hanggang sila. Mayaman pa rin sila hanggang ngayon. So, this Spaniards coming from different colonies na nawala na sa kapangyarihan ng Spanya, they transferred to Philippines. And then they were immediately appointed. They were immediately appointed by those officials who are already here. And then they were appointed by the civil officials and then the friars through this type of system, nepotismo or nepotism. Or sa Tagalog, ang tawag dyan is padrino system. What's the meaning of padrino system? It says here, dito sa balloon, this is my nephew, he's your new boss. So ibig sabihin, ito yung dating boss, pinasa niya lang yung pangyarihan dyan, that's nepotism, without any qualifications. So same thing here sa padrino system. This is actually still existing in our government offices. So if you want to work in the government, and then eventually be hired, you can only be hired dahil nga mataas yung competition, you can only be hired if you have any connection in the government. Ang tawag dyan is padrino system. Padrino system yung kahit walang qualification. Keyword here is qualification. Yung walang qualification yung mag-apply, pasok parate dahil may kaibigan o kamag-anak sa loob. That's special treatment. That's padrino system. This is one of the many examples of corruptions that we have adopted, minana natin, from the Spanish colonization. Next is no Philippine representation in the Spanish Cortes. The first word that we have to examine here is the word Cortes. So ano bang English word that we could associate here is court. Okay, if you have any complaint about someone, if you have any complaint regarding injustices, it would be very hard for the Congress. Congress, Spanish Cortes pertains to the court of the Congress. Okay, ito yung the upper house and then the lower house. So the Cortes is responsible for creating the laws. We try to elect, for the contemporary time, sa panahon ngayon, ang katumbas ng Cortes is our senators, is our congressmen. Okay. During the time of Rizal, there are no Filipino congressmen or Filipino senator. Lahat ng gumagawa ng batas natin for our country are made in favor of the Spanish officials. So, our type of government during the time is a parliament government. The parliament government or the Cortes here is responsible for creating laws, legislation, and then ito yung hearings and inquiries, kaya siya tinawag na court pa rin. So, ang gumagawa ng desisyon para magkaroon ng final decision dun sa isang kaso mo are these representatives. So, one of the many problems that we've encountered as a Filipino during the Spanish colonization is that we don't have any Filipino representation who would create laws that would be in favor of our welfare. So, it would, as a result, it would be very hard for Filipinos to expose anomalies. Ano ba yung anomalies? Strange, inconsistent act. That's why it's very easy for these officers or these Spaniards to exhibit corruption kasi nga walang magsusumbong. So in effect, nagkaroon tayo ng propaganda movement that led to the Philippine Revolution. Ito is yung mga, isa sa mga dahilan kung bakit meron tayong KKK that was created by initially by Bonifacio and then was expanded by Aguinaldo. So right now we have mandun pa rin, may anomalya tayo ngayon sa PhilHealth. If you're not familiar with PhilHealth, if you're going to be employed after college, and then this is mandatory, wala kang kalayaang hindi umindi. So PhilHealth will deduct a specific amount in your salary. So assuming we have, sabihin natin meron tayong 50 million workers in our country, and then ang i-deduct ng PhilHealth sa sahod mo, sabihin natin out of 20,000 pesos per month, ang kukunin ng PhilHealth dyan is sabihin natin nasa 300 pesos o sabihin natin 500 pesos per month. Okay, 500 pesos per month. Ang PhilHealth is an insurance wherein a portion of your hospital bills will be paid by PhilHealth. So meron tayong contribution dyan. It's mandatory assuming we have 10 million. So i-multiply mo lang yung 500 pesos sa 10 million. Lalabas mag lalabas ang PhilHealth magkakaroon ng almost 1 2 3 1 2 3 hundreds of millions. Okay, hundreds of millions collection coming from the workers. So in this case, meron tayong 15 billion. Okay, anomaly. Officials of the embattled PhilHealth have stolen some 15 billion from the agency using different fraudulent schemes, former official claims. Hindi pa rin to nare-resolve dahil nga magkakasabwat lahat ng mga nasa loob ng PhilHealth. Okay, right now, they're still planning to increase the contribution, pero it was postponed by the president. Okay, that's an example of anomaly. This is an example of parliament government. Dahil nga, balikan natin to, wala tayong representative coming from the Spanish, representative in the Spanish Cortes. So the type of government during that time is a parliament type of government. Ano ba ang parliament type of government? We, in order for us to know what's a parliament government, ito yung parliament government, we have to know our current system, which is the presidential type of government. Sa presidential type of government, meron tayong three branches in the government. The legislative, ito yung legislative, ito yung mga congress, the lower house, mga congressman. Ito yung mga representative ng bawat probinsya na gagawa ng batas in favor of each provinces. And then we have the executive branch. Ang executive branch, ito yung president and then the vice president and then yung mga departments. Ito yung mga secretaries. And then the chief executive, the president itself. Okay. Ang pipili ng mga official dyan is yung mga voters. Are the voters. That's the presidential type of government. Voters elect the legislative, the legislature, and the chief executive who is part of the executive branch. So executive, the president is the part of the executive branch. The reason why it's called executive because gagawa ng batas yung legislative, ang mag-execute niyan is the executive branch. The president and then the departments. Department of Health, Department of Public Ways, DPWH and Highways, at kung ano-ano pang departments. Okay, ang bumoboto niyan, tao. Now, for the parliament, voters elect the legislature. Ang boboto ng legislative branch, the representatives of each provinces, of each province, are the citizens. But, the legislative branch, the upper house, the Senate, and then the lower house, ang boboto ng presidente, the prime minister ang tawag dyan, the prime minister ang tatawag, ang boboto ng pipili na presidente is the legislative branch. Yan po yung pinagkaiba ng parliament sa presidential. But during our, during Rizal's time, during the Spanish colonization, walang bumoboto. Ang bumoboto, ang pumipili ng mga officials of the legislative branch are citizens coming from the country of Spain. We don't have any privilege as a Filipino to elect our representatives. Ay, doon pa lang, medyo we are actually enslaved by the power of Spain. Another element present during Rizal's time is this one. Our human rights are denied. Obviously, if we don't have any representative in the Spanish Cortes, in effect, mawawalan din tayo ng human rights. Ano ba yung human rights? Ang key word for us to appreciate human rights is our freedom. Yan lang po ang key word for the human right. Karapatan natin, may karapatan tayo bilang tao na maging malaya. And it was denied during the Spanish colonization. Are human rights still denied until today? Yes. Dahil marami pa tayong mga farmers na hindi nakaka-own ng kanilang sariling land. Ang may-ari po ng mga land right now ay mga tradisyon na namanapan natin nung panahon ng Espanya. Ito yung feudal type ownership of land. Again, keyword for human rights denied. Dahil nga wala tayong representatives in the Spanish Cortes, mawawalan tayo ng freedom. Why? That's for human rights are denied. Next, no equality before the law. So since wala nga tayong representatives sa Spanish Cortes, wala tayong congressman, wala tayong senador, obviously wala tayong, hindi natin makakamit yung tamang pagkapantay-pantay sa batas. At kung hindi tayo pantay-pantay sa batas, ang dahilan dito, the only reason why it's very hard for a common Filipino to achieve equality before the law is because of our skin color. Ang pinapabura ng batas nung panahon ni Rizal are those Spaniards na medyo light yung color ng skin. Lahat ng brown-skinned Filipinos are considered inferior. Inferior yung race natin. And we are exploited. Sa Tagalog, inaabuso. Inaabuso yung pagiging inferior natin. Since medyo ironic, medyo odd, medyo strange yung pagkocolonize sa atin ng Espanya. Why? Because we are colonized by the Spain using religion, using Catholicism. Magaling magsalita yung mga missionaries. That's why we were converted from Islam, from being a Muslim country. Ang original religion natin is Islam. Kaya nga ang head ng mga ng bawat territory natin are rajas or datus. But they were converted into Catholicism dahil nga magagaling silang magsalita. And they use death, they use God. Ang isa sa mga strange passages is this one. For religion, all men, irrespective of color, are equal before God. Pero pagdating sa batas, hindi na nagiging pantay-pantay. Okay, brown Filipinos are considered inferior and white Spaniards are considered superior. That is why namana natin yung ganung pananaw hanggang ngayon. Madalas, karamihan ng mga Pilipino are very conscious on their skin color. Sa Pilipinas lang kayo makakita ng sa Asian country, sa Pilipinas lang, which is an Asian country, sa Asia lang, na kung saan ang Pilipinas lang nagbebenta ng sabon for whitening. Okay, example of which is likas papaya. Mabenta to kasi nga we were conditioned by, we have this type of colonial mentality. We were conditioned by tradition that if your color is dark, medyo inferior yung race mo. Okay, so as a compensatory mechanism, medyo patok sa Pilipino yung paggamit ng whitening soap. Okay, that's the reason. Again, that's the reason why we cannot achieve equality before the law. Ang reason lang yan, as a result of no representation in the Spanish Cortes, ang reason lang is our skin color. And next is maladministration of justice. So since we cannot achieve equality before the law, wala tayong, our human rights are denied, it would be a chain reaction now that it's gonna be very hard for Filipinos to achieve justice. Ang hustisya nung panahon ni Rizal, even yung film na pinapanood ko sa inyo, yung Secrets of Rizal's Family, yung nanay ni Rizal was allegedly accused of poisoning the wife of poisoning his sister-in-law. Wala pang final decision, wala pang hatol, kinulong kaagad yung nanay ni Rizal. So it made Rizal very sad on how justice was served in their country that time. So nung panahon pa lang ni Rizal, meron ng maladministration of justice. Justice can be bought. It was very expensive, it was partial, and it's also very slow. 500 years ago, 300 years ago, mabagal na ang ustisya. May pagkakataon ba bumilis ang ustisya? Pag tumanda kayo, I doubt. Even right now, justice is very slow. Justice is also costly, partial, and as I mentioned a while ago, slow. Justice is only for the wealth. Ito yung sinasabing kanta ni Glock 9, ang hustisya ay para lang sa mayayaman. Justice delayed is justice denied. Now, ang character ni Juan de la Cruz, we were associated with the personhood of Juan de la Cruz. Now, if you say that Filipinos are best represented by the character of Juan de la Cruz, it's because Juan de la Cruz was imprisoned for 12 years na kung saan yung hustisya hindi binigay sa kanya. That's why pag if you associate the name Juan de la Cruz, Filipino ka agad yan. It's very may negative connotation pag si Juan de la Cruz, Filipino. Now the reason why we were called Juan de la Cruz is because Juan de la Cruz is actually a real person who was imprisoned, who wasn't able to acquire justice for 12 years. So ganun din ang mangyayari dito sa mag-ina. If you're familiar with this case, this is a policeman. Binaril niya yung mag-ina. Okay, mag-ina. Ito yung lola. Ito yung anak niya. Yung anak niya medyo lasing. Ito yung anak ng polis. O yung complain lang ng polis, paingay yung kapitbahay nila. Before New Year to, nagpapaputok ng boga. Medyo nakainom kasi itong lalaki. So medyo nawala yung respeto ng lalaki, including the lola, the mother, dun sa polis. Tapos binibidyo ng anak, right in front of her daughter, binaril tong dalawa. So right now, wala pa rin desisyon, although malino naman sa video na ito na yung bumaril. And then this police man over here is denying yung offense niya, yung hinatol sa kanyang allegation. So that's a concrete example of maladministration of justice. Ang keyword natin for maladministration of justice, ang hustisya ay para lang sa mayaman. So we have no equality before the law. Primarily, the reason behind that is because of our skin color. It's very hard for Filipinos to achieve equality and justice because of our skin color. Spaniards are calling us Indios. Tinatawag tayong Indio. It's derived from the Indians na local ng native residents ng Amerika. So ano bang appearance ng Indians? Dark yung color at medyo flat yung nose. Ito yung actual photo ng mga Filipinas during the time of Rizal. So if you're going to notice, they have the same type of color. And then as a reaction, tinatawag ng mga Pilipino yung mga Spaniards na bangus or milkfish. I have this impression na the reason why they were calling as a response dun sa Indios, ang dahilan kung bakit tinatawag ng mga Pilipino yung mga Spaniards na bangus is because bangus is balansa. So most probably since they are not accustomed in having or maligo araw-araw yung mga Western individuals, so most likely itong mga Spaniards hindi sila naliligo araw-araw dito sa bansa natin. Kaya amoy, malansa sila. Ang tawag sa kanila ng mga Pilipino, mga angus or fish. Ito naman yung contemporary appearance of a Filipino, si Kuya Jobert. So, we have racial discrimination during the time of Rizal. A Spaniard during that time, kahit na anong hindi siya qualified dahil nga we have a Padrino system, parati nila na i-enjoy yung political and social prestige and superiority. This is the problem of colonialization. This is the problem of colonialism. The next problem encountered during the time of Rizal is phrenocracy. Phrenocracy is a combination of the power of the church and then the power of the government. So, during the time of Rizal, the church and then the government are equal. Ito yung ginawang, isa sa mga ginawang policy in our constitution. The church and then the government will always be separated. There's always, under our constitution, the church and then the government are always separated. So during the government of Rizal, it's a government of friars. Friars here pertain to our priests, Catholic priests. They have a very tremendous political power, influence, and riches. Ang tanong, present pa ba to hanggang ngayon? If you're going to check, this is an actual wealth of our Catholic priests right now. The Catholic archbishops, yung mga bishop ng simbahan, they are the biggest stockholders of BPI. Meron silang 30 billion pesos na pagmamayari na stock sa BPI. I'm going to upload this book, Altar of Secrets. It's a very intriguing book about our Catholic priests. Ipinakita dito yung corruption ng simbahan. May mga paring nakabuntis, may mga anak, may mga paring binubulsa yung mga contributions sa simbahan. May mga, if you have time, I'll be uploading this book in our Big Sky and then you can read it out. Now, why did I include this book? This is in reference to Rizal's two novels, Nolime Tangere and then El Filibusterismo. Nung panahon din ni Gloria Macapagal Arroyo, may mga bishops sa Pampanga na tumanggap ng pera at mga SUV para lang suportahan si Arroyo. Okay, dun sa libro makikita niyo yung corruption pa rin ng simbahan. So ulitin ko, ba't ko siya nilagay? This is in reference to Rizal's attack on the Catholic Church, which is present dun sa Nolime Tangere niya at saka sa El Filibusterismo. Ang pinakasikat na character dun sa na pinotray dun sa novel ni Rizal are two Catholic priests, si Padre Damaso, si Padre Salvi. Now, if merong Bible passage na mag-ingat kayo sa mga pastor na nagsusuot ng nanagaan yung tupa pero deep within inside ay para silang mga lobo, para silang mga wolf na anytime handa kayong gawing pain. So ang tanong, why is it very consistent? Napaka-consistent ng observation ni Rizal during his time. Okay, that's almost several hundred years ago. Hanggang ngayon, present pa rin sa simbahan. Malaking tanong. Ngayon, if the Catholic religion is actually considered as a real religion pa rin. Because of leaders, corrupt leaders who are leading people to follow them. Next is forced labor.